He is a star on the big and small screens, but in his latest role, Gyton Grantley is being upstaged, well, by a bit of a mongrel.
Oh.
You see, Gyton is starring alongside George, a 3.5-year-old rescue dog who's got heaps of personality. And Gyton and George join us now.
Oh. Hey.
Yeah,
you're
nice to meet
you.
Yeah. Hello.
Oh.
Good boy, Georgie.
Wow. Hello to you as well.
Hi, Jessica. Nice to meet you. Yeah,
lovely to meet
Tell
you.
Tell us about your beautiful dog.
He's just like an actor, but he takes direction
really well. Well, George, sit down.
Hello.
Sit.
Good boy. I'll do anything when you've got a treat. Do you want to try, Patty?
I've given it one of mine.
A treat?
Yeah. Abandoned, wasn't he? Someone abandoned this beautiful dog.
Yeah, well, we did get him from a pet store, but the litter was abandoned, and so they checked out the pups, and they were all fine, and so he's a lab kelpie, we think.
He's gorgeous. How old is he?
He's 3.5 now.
Okay.
I'm hungry.
But being a kelpie is a lot of energy.
Yes.
Yeah. Lots of fun too. So
can I just say before we get onto the dog and your new show, you have done some wonderful, wonderful acting in so many things.
You have.
He's brilliant. Really fabulous. Underbelly, and that was fantastic.
Husbands. Yes, House Husbands, that was fun too. Lots of films that have been.
Are you really gay?
Am I not? I'm married with a 10-month-old baby boy.
You are. Yes, I read about that in one of those magazines.
I'll take that as a compliment, Patty.
No, well, see, you can't believe what you read in the magazines, but Patty knows that.
No, I've been a convincing drug-dealing murderer. I've been a convincing gay husband. And
What's coming
I've
up
I've just
next?
Played a paedophile in a film called Don't Tell.
Oh, that's brilliant. Right, how is that? How do you play a paedophile when you have a 10-month-old little boy at home? That must kind of... I know it's acting,
but... Well, it's not an easy choice. No, it's not something that I... Not my... the biggest role I just jumped at. I had to really consider it, actually, before I decided I wanted to do it. But I guess in the end of the day, if you're an actor, you can't judge your character.
Of course.
Nobody in life thinks that they're wrong or evil. Well, maybe they think they're wrong, but no one thinks they're a bad person unless you're a psychopath, really. So you've got to get into their psyche and understand why they do the things they do.
Does that sort of screw you up, though? Like, there was talk about, you know, Heath Ledger when he was playing the Joker was so far into the role that it really affected him.
Yeah.
That's right. Does it? Yeah. Or are you able to separate it?
I'm pretty good at that, yeah. There's times I played a mentally, a challenged... boy or well, man in The Dressmaker. There was never really any kind of actual medical assessment because it was, 1920s or something. But I did had a lot of, physical traits and they were kind of ingrained in my muscle memory. So my wife would say sometimes I'd wave goodbye and I'd just be like, bye. Things like that. So there is some kind of residue that stays around. But I think the mental kind of... It wasn't too gratuitous what we did in this film either. So it wasn't too, hard in that respect. It's just...
Did you have to get into the method to do the dog show too?
Yes, the Pooches show that's coming up.
Well, yeah, it's my first time as a host. So that's been not a challenge, but just a joy and really refreshing and fun.
With all different doggies.
Yeah, many different dogs. And that's the idea. So Pooches at Play is just about how much we love hanging out with our pooches and playing with them. And all the fun things we can do and places to take
them. So what do you and George like to do?
Well, we live near a creek, so we walk along the creek all the time. And having being half lab and kelpie, I guess, he loves to swim. So he's a big swimmer in the Yarra and down in the bay too. He loves to chase the ball and swim.
It looks like he's smiling.
Yeah.
He's such a smiley dog.
He's a natural. Look at him. He's like, this is where I'm meant to be.
Yeah.
38% of households have a dog. Yeah. I mean, it's amazing.
Yeah,
so then you've got 38% of the audience already.
Absolutely.
Yeah. 62% probably have cats then. Dare I say?
Should throw in the odd cat.
Your maths is good, Jess.
I was thinking.
Throw in a cat, you've got us all.
Absolutely. Yeah. Oh, look, we're not biased towards just dogs. We love all animals. But
we're not speciesist.
No, we're not speciesist. But Lara, my co-host, and I, we're both just huge dog lovers. Aww. So it just makes sense that we...
You know what dogs really love is when you scratch their underbelly.
You can give it a try.
Anything you touch, Gyton Grantley, turns to gold. Yeah. So we can't wait to see this. It's true. Pooches at Play premieres tomorrow afternoon at 2:30 on Network 10 and Win. Please thank Gyton and George.